It took 41 rocket launches just to bring the building materials to the construction site, and more than 100 other launches along the way to ferry up the human crew members and deliver the supplies they would need to live and work. The largest peacetime engineering and construction project in human history. And it wouldn't have happened if the nations of the world hadn't joined forces. But they did. And that cooperative spirit is alive and thriving right now on board the International Space Station. The major space agencies of the world each have their own independent exploration program. Yet they work together on one project that's vital to humankind's future in space. Operating a joint research laboratory and technology development station 250 miles above the Earth. The United States, Russia, Japan, Canada, and the nations of Europe each provide and train crew members who operate this space station.
We have come to know each other very well, to really enjoy each other's company, enjoy working together. I consider them very close friends.
При нашем взаимодействии внутри корабля, вот мы отталкиваемся прежде всего от целей и задач, почему именно мы сидим в этом корабле. И поэтому у нас никаких особых проблем во взаимодействии никаких нет. Силу нашей профессиональной способности.
I think each country has its unique strengths and good part and also a weakness. So if we cooperate each other, we can cover the other nation's weak part and help each other.
Over the years, the partners have contributed the vehicles that bring human beings to orbit and the ones that make regular deliveries of supplies and materials. Plus all the hardware and samples to operate a set of scientific laboratories and experiments that are achieving things that couldn't be done on Earth. The results, in terms of science and technology development, are out of this world.
Having different perspectives, either different scientific perspectives, different international perspectives, has helped bring strength to the work that we do. We've gotten to work with some incredible people around the globe, and that we found what we think are some significant findings.
The Alpha Magnetic Spectrometer is a high-energy particle physics experiment designed to study cosmic rays, antimatter, dark matter, and dark energy. There's 15 countries, about 600 engineers, physicists, scientists, technicians, about 60 different institutes, universities, all over the planet. You get the interaction of all these people, and in the end, you have something that's a whole lot better than what you had done by yourself.
Each space agency takes responsibility for a part of the mission by operating a control room in their own country, which focuses on daily operations in their own labs and modules. The heart of the overall operation is at NASA's Mission Control Center in Houston, where a team coordinates what all the partners are doing.
The ESPLAN team takes all of the requirements handed down from the ISS program, from the international partners, from the flight control team, and from the science community. And we integrate all of those requirements into a timeline, and we uplink it to the crew, and that's how the crew knows what to do on a given day.
With all that effort, over all these years, the partners in the International Space Station have created something that's already provided benefits on Earth and encouraged the growth of a commercial space industry, and is perfectly positioned to continue that mission. Supporting future human exploration into deep space.
If you think about all the capability that's on the space station today, it brought out the best in each of the partners. The only way for exploration to be successful is to have that global partnership together as we have had so far with the space station.
We're going to use the technology of the ATV, 5 very successful ISS resupply missions to make this incredible contribution to the Orion spacecraft. So the service module will be a very critical part to the Orion spacecraft. It will provide power, it will provide thermal control, and most importantly, it will provide propulsion to the crew module.
Building on the robotic technology we developed to support the space shuttle program and then to build, to assemble the space station, Canada's developed a next generation Canadarm. This is a state-of-the-art suite of robotics prototypes that will be able to support the critical next steps in exploring the solar system.
У нас в России есть такая поговорка, что один ум хорошо, а два еще лучше. Но две и три – это гораздо лучше, потому что, работая в кооперации международной, люди гораздо лучше начинают понимать друг друга.
Better understanding and a common goal combine for a great future out there.